There has been a murder at the palace. I need you to be careful with this one. Anti-royalist pamphlets have been cropping up and tensions are high. The Queen is very nervous about security. This way. This way. Here we are. Good luck.
Well now, I didn't ask about this. Well now, I didn't ask about this.
Please, leave the room for a moment. No one is permitted to see me open the safe. Imagine that someone was after the scepter. I must see it. I ordered the scepter with the dove to be brought from the tower for tonight's event. Thank heavens! It is untouched.
Poor man. I arrived to find him here, dead as you see him. He gave his life to defend my person. Only I know the combination. The vault contains the very precious scepter. scepter with the dove, which I've chosen to be used in tonight's knighthood ceremony. This evening, I will knight several industrialists that have worked to end the practice of child labor. All of London's luminaries are invited.
There's some sort of master criminal on the loose. Then this morning, he's gone.
He said he was onto something. Said everything, added in clues.
I did see Artie's friend, Mr. Raymond. He'd just come from Purlock Publishing with his new Penny Dreadful. Seemed very excited about it. I never liked him much.
Now, I didn't ask about this.
Come to think of it, he had been going on about the Queen and all for the last day or two. Seemed to think she was in some sort of trouble.
You know, when he thought something was important, he'd write it up in invisible ink. Lemon juice-like. He'd use smoke to read it. If you have a way to make smoke, you can see what it says.
He's planning an explosion at the palace. It must be evacuated.
Excuse me.
Whoa now.
Summon Mr. Shaw. Yeah.
At least 100 people here for the knighthood ceremony. The queen will use the scepter with the dove for the knighting. She'll arrive precisely at 1 o'clock.
Danger!
Now is your time. explosion! Run! Out!
Mr. Fogg, I grant you leave to order me to leave.
Good. They're out. Why is nothing happening? Nothing? What's going on? I've been tricked! Raymond! Why has he done this?
You are more naive than you appear.
Look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances. Look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances. Look beyond the obvious.
Nothing but a showman. So many people makes everything more dramatic.
I found the same clues you found. I knew there was to be an explosion, and I led you here to save everyone. I'm as mystified as you are that nothing happened. Seems to me you've created the perfect diversion, haven't you? You've helped me herd all those dreary people to certain death. We shall hear the explosion presently. Quite right.
I brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony, the one with the special scepter.
Mm-hmm.
Never trust a man who tells you what you want to hear. He's after something.
While you were chasing all those people around, I absconded with the Queen. A hefty ransom is now due. I needed you to distract everyone so that I could quietly assassinate Her Majesty the Queen. A man like me can take anything he wants, even the Queen's most beloved item of all her crown jewels, the priceless and symbolic scepter with the dove. The scepter with the dove taken with your help. What could better display my genius?
No one questions you when you wear a uniform.
I suspect the solution will turn on geometry.
I am a fellow of many skills. Cracking a safe is but one. I simply watched the Queen open the safe when you arrived. I threatened the Queen with her very life. She told me the combination in a trice. Quite right. The dead guard was I. The spider venom allowed me to fake my death. I had a perfect view from where I lay. I have stolen the Queen's most prized possession, the scepter with the dove. Think of it. I have outfoxed you, the most cunning detective in Britain. I mocked you by leaving clues for you at every turning point. Now I have the scepter. Proof positive of my superiority.
Jacob, wake up! It's Raymond. He's taken Artie hostage. They're on the roof. Evie's here to help you, Jacob.
This lad's very life depends upon it.
You have done well.
Don't worry, Jacob. He won't know it's coming.
Thank you.
Yes, but Artie here is a trump card, is he not?
Don't do anything foolish, Mr. Raymond. Let young Artie go and you and I can solve this, just the two of us. What do you say?
I appreciate your efforts, but I don't have much reason to trust you. Now do I, Mr. Fry?
I suppose this means our detective days are over. But what about you, Artie?
I'm glad I survived Mr. Raymond's insanity, but sadly he won't be here anymore to write more books.
A great loss, I'm sure.
I'm quite serious, Miss Evie. Me and my friends waited every week to read the next number and find out what happened next.
Why don't you write some yourself?
A fellow would have to be very clever indeed.
Sounds like you'd be in your element, my dear.
The gruesome Whitechapel murders by Artie.
I should think I would use my full name, by Artie Conan Doyle.
Artie's Arthur. Sounds more of a serious fellow.
Do not get too close!